Here we are for another Westflix interview. Today we're with Lauren Rothman and Mila Danton. They were both directors in 2017 of the festival, and thank you so much for coming today.
Thanks for having us.
Of course.
It's great to be back.
Yeah. What was your experience like as a Westflix director?
Do you want to answer first?
Yeah.
It was a really special experience, to simplify it, but I think what was so lovely about it is we were able to work on projects and have all the resources to create promo videos and have access to a lot of really talented filmmakers and just get to create things and interact with people in our community in a really special way and have a platform to display all our work was really wonderful. And it was a great place to learn and sort of, as we were leaving Harvard Westlake in our last year, to realize that we truly wanted to go into film as a professional in our career. So that was really great just to practice it and get to work with other people in the same field. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
She said it very well. I think it was also just a really fun time as seniors to get to bond with each other and have something that we were all really passionate about and work together and produce something that we were all proud of. So, mm-hmm.
Yeah, we became really close friends with the festival, which was nice.
Yeah.
It brought a lot of unexpected friendships out of it in a great way. It was just because
we all
got,
did.
We became so close. It was a family.
Yeah.
And we all were passionate about the same things.
Yeah.
It was nice to find common ground in that.
Yeah,
yeah,
for sure. That's awesome. And then also, what was like your favorite moment or memory from like putting the festival together that really stands out to you?
I feel like that was really fun.
Yeah.
Because we were able to pull off something that we didn't think that we was really feasible.
Yeah. Well, everybody else didn't think. We knew it was feasible. Everybody else told us it was
ambitious.
Not feasible.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. But we had a vision that we wanted to do it like the opening scene in La La Land, because that film came out
that year,
that Christmas
yeah.
of senior year, and everyone was talking about it because
yeah.
especially just it was very nostalgic and it had musical numbers, but it was also a romance and it had all these pieces, and we thought it'd be a really great template to apply to a promo video.
Yeah.
So just whether we were laying down new lyrics for the songs, that was a whole new process that we learned a lot about songwriting and I'm not particularly good at it. Lauren was really good at it, I was not. And then when we were able to shoot the whole thing on campus and get other people involved in different groups, you know, we had the whole dance team in one little section of the project and we shot on the weekends and it didn't feel like a chore. It felt mm-hmm. like
it was so fun.
A passion project, a mini one, it was really fun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That video is amazing. We watched it as like a reference this year for like
aww.
What like a promo video like it, like the best type of promo video. So yeah. And when the festival like finally kicked off, how did you feel like when you saw all your hard work like pay off in a way?
It felt really nice. I think that question makes us think of when we actually got into the theater. We didn't have room to actually sit because we had filled like the entire theater at the Arclight. So we ended up sitting like in the very back at the top on the floor. We sat on the floor and it was awesome. It was like the best feeling of, you know, very, very big accomplishment. But, you know, the fact that we had managed to actually fill the entire thing, it had never been done before. And
yeah, it felt like a shared experience.
Yeah.
When you're working on the festival, you're in the weeds and you're really close to everything that you're gonna display and share with the community, and you realize that this is something that's a public experience, and then when you kind of are promoting it at school with mm-hmm. other students and classmates and the faculty, and you're not sure if everyone is as interested as you are in it, you know, you're just saying things and you're thinking,
you're
okay, well,
to avoid.
Hopefully that someone will show up, and it was really amazing when everyone kind of came out for it and was curious about what people were making, and I think the promo video also got people excited, and that's why we also loved it. It just became more than just the five of us making something. It was the whole school was a part of it in a certain way.
In our grade.
The teachers were a huge part of the whole process as well. And that was one of my favorite parts of it because we got to become so close with the faculty, not just students, but also these adults who had lots of life experience and perspective and gave us really great feedback and guided us through the whole process. We couldn't have done it without them. And,
yeah.
Ms. Skalky, Mr. O'Malley, and Mr. Walsh were the best.
Yeah.
Yeah, we got really lucky.
And just finally, if you could possibly describe Westflix in a single word, what would that word be?
You go first.
I was going to say gateway, but not in the way, kind of like a gateway drug. and then I was like, maybe I should use like precipice or something. But it's like a door opening to, at least for both of us, I think it really jump-started our professional lives.
Yeah.
Because it was really fun. That was the first word that came to mind. But it wasn't just fun. We were actually learning all of these skills and disciplines of, you know, getting all the submissions in and dealing with the submissions and contacting people and emailing people and, you know, dealing with artists and wrangling talent and all of that, all of those skills that, you know, we've now taken into our careers. I think it was the perfect mix of passion and also learning to kind of be an adult about, you know, organizing something big.
Yeah, you know. That's really well said. I agree. Because a lot of what you're doing is, it's not so different than what we do in our careers now.
Yeah.
It's very similar. It's a different scale. But I think it was also great to be learning in that really healthy, safe environment too, how to do those skills. And, you know, if you really want to go into entertainment, it's a good kind of testing area, yeah, testing ground to see, okay, so it requires all these things. I have to be able to communicate with people and also be involved in the creative and collaborate with other people. And, mm-hmm, you know, are these all the things that I want to have in my career?
Yeah.
So that was a huge part for me too. I guess one word, I would just say opportunity is my word, because similarly to what you said, it's, you get a taste of what the real world is also like, but you're at a place where you're surrounded by very intelligent, talented people, and then you also have the resources to create something that you're for a vision and fulfill it, you know what I mean? And a lot of times you have an idea for something, but you don't really have the means to create it, and here you did. And you also have the faculty and the community to lift you up, and I think that was a huge part of it. It's, yeah.
And it's not so different from professional work. I mean, look at the talent that we had. I don't know who I don't know who coordinated their glam and their cars and everything, but it's not like we're dealing with. I mean, I work in talent management now, and getting actors to events like this is not easy, and it's not simple. I don't know who did it for us. I don't know if it was.
It was probably Jillian or PR team. I don't know.
But I mean, it's so cool, the fact that we had two actors of that magnitude just show up. They did their own hair and makeup. They dressed themselves. Like, this seems like not a big deal, but it is, and it just shows how special Harvard Westlake is and the connections that the community has. It's like, you don't get that anywhere else. You don't get these actors and this talent just, you know, happy to be there and happy to show up to your festival and the day after and like do a workshop with kids. I mean, it's
very hands on.
We're so lucky though that we had that.
And every year it amazes me what students create and what the festival does, because it always improves every single year, and it's building off of what happened before. And I love that there's a history there with the Westlake Film Festival, and it's probably going to go on for
forever.
What's also great about it is there's a tradition there.
Yeah.
Like a family.
Yeah. Well, thank you so much for coming in and talking with us today.
Thanks for having us.
Really
us.
Appreciate it. Yeah. Thank
We're
you.
Excited
okay.
for you guys.
Yes. Yeah. And come on March 17th, the Million Dollar Theater.
Oh, where is it?
Go.
That's downtown.
Yeah, we're just doing it there. At least this year. We don't know if it'll be in the future, but for the 20th anniversary.
Is it the 20th anniversary?
You gotta go.
I didn't know that.
You gotta.
March 17th. What's on March 17th? 2000?
Yeah.
Oh, if James were here, he'd be like, let's go.
I hear them every day. The rhythms in the lounge that'll never fade away. The ballads in the classrooms left by those who came before. They tell us what we're waiting for. So much fun we have in store.